Saturday, 30th August, and this is Top Stories by Rooster News. An Indian Navy warship of the Western Naval Command, patrolling the Gulf of Aden, rushed to the help of a Norwegian vessel after its all-Indian crew sent a distress call on August 25th. MV Vela was in deep trouble as its port anchor and 330-meter-long cable, weighing approximately 42 tons, had slipped into the Gulf of Aden. A naval spokesperson said the ship was severely disabled, with her speed being restricted to 5 to 6 knots. It made her vulnerable to piracy attacks. Apart from being a navigational hazard for itself, she also posed a danger to other ships in the dense shipping corridor. INS Tej quickly dispatched a specialist team to carry out an assessment of the situation and provide assistance for the recovery of the anchor and the cable. A naval spokesperson said, "This evolution not only ensured safe voyage of MV Vela, but also averted a huge financial loss." Over 1 lakh office goers from Chennai and parts of Tamil Nadu are taking to carpooling. Ballpark estimates show that the two largest carpooling apps that cater to the corporate sector, S-Ride and QuickRide, have 80,000 users each. In Chennai, more and more techies are carpooling. Data provided by S-Ride show employees of TCS, Capgemini, Cognizant, Wipro and Ford as the top 5 carpoolers. Techies from OMR, a big IT hub in Chennai, attributed 5 reasons for carpooling taking off: cost savings, safety especially for women employees, environmental issues, networking and convenience. The founder of QuickRide, K.N.M Rao, said that carpoolers were offered incentives by companies in the form of preferred parking. He also suggested that the state government and the companies could do more in terms of incentivizing the concept of carpooling, given the benefits involved in terms of infrastructure and emissions. Those into the business of carpooling apps said that they were, on average, witnessing a growth of 40 to 60% in terms of new users joining each month. India is set to get more disaster warning systems along its course. While it already has a tsunami warning system in place, the new systems will keep an eye out for tsunamis and storm surges, according to an official release. The system is part of a program called OSMART that is being piloted by the Union Earth Sciences Ministry. It was cleared by the Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs on Wednesday at an outlay of 1623 crores. OSMART will provide economic benefits to a number of user communities in coastal and ocean sectors, namely fisheries, offshore industry, coastal states, defense and shipping. Other key missions under OSMART include strengthening of ocean observations and modeling, strengthening of ocean services for fishermen, setting up marine observatories for monitoring pollution, and exploration of minerals and living resources, amongst others. A day after several human rights activists were arrested across the country, a few Delhiites gathered outside Maharashtra Sadan yesterday to voice their protest against the action by the Maharashtra police. The protesters demanded the release of the arrested activists and academicians, including poet Varavara Rao in Hyderabad, Gautam Navlakha in Delhi, Sudha Bharadwaj in Faridabad, activist Vernon Gonsalves in Mumbai, and activist Arun Ferreira in Chhattisgarh. The Maharashtra police have accused the activists of involvement in Bhima Koregaon violence in the state in 2017. Several people at the protest, who braved the heavy rain, said that they were out on the streets as they felt it was their duty as citizens to call the government out when something wrong was being done. Delhi College professor Sardar Shiv said, "I'm here to protest against these unlawful arrests. It is my duty as a citizen." Environmental clearance has been accorded to the 162 km long Chennai Peripheral Road that will connect Puncheri near Mamallapuram with Kattupalli in Thiruvallur district. Official sources said that the clearance was recently granted by the State Environmental Impact Assessment Authority on the condition that the project could be taken up after obtaining due coastal regulation zone clearance. The project, which is likely to cost around 12,500 crores, will be taken up in phases with funding from the Japan International Cooperation Agency, an agreement for which is to be signed shortly, the sources said. The road, which is 6-lane wide with 2 service lanes on either side, will also have space for a utilities corridor to carry oil and gas pipelines, since the road connects industrial hubs. We round up this newscast with fuel prices from key metros. In Delhi, petrol is sold for 78.23 rupees per litre and diesel for 69.80 rupees per litre. In Chennai, petrol is sold for 81.28 rupees per litre and diesel for 73.74 rupees per litre. In Kolkata, petrol is sold for 81.16 rupees per litre and diesel for 72.64 rupees per litre. In Mumbai, petrol is sold for 85.65 rupees per litre and diesel for 74.10 rupees per litre.